Dear friend, namaste. We are in day 21. Today we discuss here about change of state. Okay? Change of state. So, just like change of state, we must see here, we clear. This is solid, ice is solid, water is liquid, vapor is gas. No? Solid is ice, while making the ice, it changes into water. Further heating, it changes into vapor. Here, this phenomena is known as change of state. Okay? So, change of state takes place when there is loss or gain of heat. Means it depends upon this term. Loss or gain of heat. Loss or gain of heat. Changes of state take place when there is loss or gain of heat. While changing the state, the substance either absorbs or releases heat. Okay, substance either they release heat or absorb heat. On heating, solid change to liquid through the motion of its molecules. Similarly, liquid changes to vapor on heating. Are you clear? Okay. If we cool gas, it changes into liquid. Yes, if we cool gas with vapor, okay, then it changes into liquid, and for the cooling, it changes into solid. Yes, this is. Understood, dear student?
Yes.
So, we can say here, the temperature at which ice melts into water is permeability of ice. Okay? Okay, student? Okay, so see here, the temperature at which ice melts into water is called melting point of ice. Okay, the temperature at which ice melts into water. If anybody asks you what is melting point of ice, then you say the temperature of which ice melts into water. Ice melts into water is called melting point of ice. Similarly, the temperature at which water freezes into ice is called freezing point. Means temperature at which water freezes into ice is called freezing point. Okay, the constant temperature at which water changes into gases state is called its boiling point. What is boiling point? If anybody asks you, then you say the constant temperature at which water changes into gaseous state. If water changes into gaseous state, then its boiling point. If ice melts into water, is called melting point. If water freezes into ice, is called freezing point. Any confusion, student? So see the chart here. This is solid, this is liquid, this is gas. I had made the arrow two sides. Two arrow here, two arrow here, two arrow here. So see here, from solid, I have made the arrow and there is gas, liquid. See? From solid, it's when it melts, solid melts, then it converted into liquid. Then actually, when vaporization means when vapor comes, then it changes into gas. From solid, see here, from solid, this line, the line, means when it melts, then it changes into liquid. Then, but when vaporization, after vaporization, it changes into gas. Again, from gas to liquid, see here, when we cool the gas, then it becomes a solid. Alright? When gas cools, then it becomes a solid. This is the one way. We have talked about melting, vaporization, then cooling. Okay? Again, see here, from solid, we can make the gas with sublimation, with the help of sublimation. Okay? Isn't it? Directly. Thereafter, from gas to liquid, you can make condensation. Condensation. Thereafter, liquid to solid, solidification. Solidification. So, dear student, sometimes substances like naphthalene, camphor, iodine, etc. directly change into gas. Really, camphor, iodine, when give heat, they directly change into gas on heating and directly change into solid on cooling. Such solids are called volatile solids. The process by which a solid substance directly changes into vapor due to heating and is converted to solid again on cooling is called sublimation. Okay, dear student. So we have discussed about discharge. What is how sublimation means when from gas directly when solid changes its state directly to the gas, it is known as sublimation. When gas directly changes into liquid, then it is called condensation. And when liquid directly changes into solid state, it's called solidification. Okay? So I think you are clear here. So now discuss here physical changes and chemical changes. First, we are going to discuss here physical changes. What type of changes is called physical changes? So basically, the changes in which no new substance is formed. No new substance is formed and the substance only undergoes a change in its shape, size, appearance or state is known as a physical change. Means no new substance is formed and only undergoes or changes in its size, shape, appearance or state is for physical change. Just example, breaking of a pencil. Suppose one pencil is here. Suppose one pencil, and it will break from here. So it might be like this. Okay, like this. It can like this, look like this. Yeah. So some example of physical change is tearing of paper into pieces. Next example is bending of iron. Iron can bend. That is also a physical change. Conversation of ice into water. Cool. Knitting of sweater. Sweep, short pant, etc. from raw clothes. They are the examples. Okay? Understood? Very good. So, chemical changes. The changes in which new substance is formed. With different properties from the original substance. Is called chemical changes. Will be clear from example here. Chemical changes cause formation of new substance. Means suppose this is a one substance, yeah, when we bond it, then it changes into next. The properties also can change of this marker. So example, when a wood is bond, it changes in wire patterns. Really, when wood change, suppose if you bond this white board, then it bond, yeah, it bond and it changes into coil. It might be changing to coil, yes, like this, etc. So all the properties of wood is changed. Some example of chemical changes are conversion of milk, just example, milk to cheese. Okay? Rusting of iron. Burning charcoal. Digestion of food, etc. Okay? So we can differentiate between physical changes and chemical changes. First number, physical change. Physical change is the change of state of substance, but chemical change is a change of matter itself. Am I right? Second is, it is a temporary, physical change is a temporary change, but chemical change is a permanent change. Okay? Third one is, only physical properties such as shape, size, state, and mass, it is a change, but chemical changes, physical as well as chemical composition changes. Fourth number, physical change is reversible, but chemical change is irreversible, reversible. Okay? This is example you can say of physical changes, magnetizing an iron, folding of cloth, etc. or breaking the pencil. But the example of chemical changes is rusting of iron, formation of part from milk, burning of food, they are the examples. So dear student, today this much, next class we will study classification of matter. Okay, thank you dear student, thank you. So we will discuss in next class. Goodbye dear student, thank you.